हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लेसन. द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज ऑन गेटिंग अप कोल्ड मॉर्निंग्स. दिस एसे इज रिटन बाय ले हंट, एन एमिनेंट फिलोसोफर, राइटर, पोइट, एसिस्ट. I introduce myself as Dr. S.R. Bhargav, Department of English, Associate Professor. As we know that the topic is very interesting and relevant because it is the habit of everyone to get up early in the cold morning and makes practice. But some people are not happy to get up early in the cold mornings, and some are very happy. So in the essay, the writer has tried to convince the readers that there are so many benefits of getting early rising. And according to others, like lazy and circus, who are not able to get up early, and they make excuses for their health, for their so many things. And even the old people or even the ill sick people, they also are not able to rise up early because of their so many health problems. But the writer says that it is the necessity of our life to get up early and start a good day. Get up on cold mornings by Le Hunt, an Italian author, Giulio Caruda. A Jesuit has written a poem upon insects, which he begins by insisting that those troublesome and abominable little animals were created for our annoyance, and that they were certainly not inhabitants of paradise. We of the North may dispute this piece of theology, but on the other hand, it is clear as the snow on the housetops that Adam was not under the necessity of shaving, and that when Eve walked out of her delicious bower, she did not stop upon ice 3 inches thick. The writer goes back to history, saying that when the earth was empty, inhabitant, without any person, two persons, the representative of the God, Adam and Eve, they were born and they were sent to punishment, prison, because of their crime done against the God. The crime is believed that they had tasted or eaten the prohibited or forbidden fruit. And it was a punishment for those who get up early in the morning. He says that this essay may be an nuisance for the people, that in the beginning animals were created and for them the people had to rise up early because of their so many causes. And it was not necessary that Adam and Eve could not get up early because they don't have shavings, they have don't any walkings on the ice mountains. Some people say it's a very easy thing to get up of a cold morning. You have only. They tell you to take the resolution and the thing is done. This may be very true. Just as a boy at school has only to take a flogging and things is over. But we have not at all made up our minds upon it, and we find it's a very pleasant exercise to discuss the matter. Candidly, before we get up, this at least it's not an idling, though it may be lying. It affords an excellent answer to those who ask how lying in bed can be indulged in by a reasoning being, a rational creature. How? Why with the argument calmly at work in one's head, and the clothes over one's shoulder, it's a fine way of spending a sensible, impartial half hour. The writer says that in the world there are two types of people, one who is like to get up early and another is that not like to get up early. It is the belief of some people that it's very easy to get up in the cold morning, and others people have many reasons. They tell you to take the resolution. Resolution means they determine to do so and the thing is done or the work is done. This may be very true as a boy of school has only to take a flogging and the thing is over. It's like a game for the school student who thinks and does according to his will. But we have not at all made up our minds upon it. We, the mature people, we do not bother about that we have to do or we are not going to do. And we find it's a very pleasant exercise to discuss the matter. Candidly means frankly. Before we get up, this at least is not idling, though it may be lying. The writer says that some people are lazy, but they are so lazy that they don't want to rise up. It affords an excellent answer to those who ask how lying in bed can be indulged in by reasoning of being a rational creature. The writer says that if the people who are not able to, who are not interested to get up early, they are like those animals that they lie in a lazy or lie at a lethargic manner. How? Why with the argument calmly at work in one's head and the cloth over one's shoulder? Oh, it's a fine way of spending a sensible, impartial half hour. So the writer says that we have to rise early in the early morning because it makes us healthy, wealthy and active. If these people would be more charitable, they would get on with their argument better. But they are apt to reason so ill and to assert so dogmatically that one could wish to have them stand round one's bed of a bitter morning. Some people say that it's a matter of charity because the arguments may come, but it is the matter of charity if we think that the people who are ill, they claim that they want to go outside, they want to make round, but they are so lazy that they say that in the bitter morning, cold shivering morning, they can make a round around their bed so that they can become very healthy and lie before their faces. Oh, they make practices. They ought to hear both sides of the bed, the inside and out. If they can't entertain themselves with their own thoughts for half an hour or so, it's not the fault of those who can. The writer says that if they are not able to entertain themselves, they have their own thoughts, they have their own time. But it's not the blame of those people that they are forced to do so. They may be luckier in the connection that they are happy at their own position. On my first movement towards the anticipation of getting up, I find that such parts of the seats and bolster. The writer says that when he guesses about the time of getting up in the cold shivering, he feels that he is surrounded by the covers matter, and whenever he comes outside in the open air from his bedroom, he feels that though the stones are icy cold, yet when he opens his eyes, and opening my eyes, the first thing that meets them is my own breath rolling forth. The writer says that it's a very crucial time in the cold morning when he rises from the bed and opens his mouth. The steam comes from his mouth in the form of air, smoke, fog, and makes a roll. Because it's the time of fog.
the like smoke out of a cottage chimney. Think of the symptom, then I turn my eyes sideways and see the windows all frozen over. And after that scene, the writer sees that the atmosphere is fully frozen. The windows are covered with ice. The air is very tight. And think of that, then the servant comes in. It's very cold this morning. It's not very cold, sir. Very cold indeed, isn't it? Very cold indeed, sir. More than usually so. Isn't it even for this weather? The writer quotes from his servant's dialogue, saying that whenever he tries unwillingly or willingly, his servant comes and advises him not to go outside because of the very cold, bitter morning. It's very cold, sir. Very cold.